Back at another filament drying video, but this time quite different. A few months ago I did a review of that Weber analytical scale. There I was analyzing drying of this PETG filament, and at the end of that video I placed it in the microwave just for quick testing, and the results are quite interesting, and then I got quite a lot of useful comments. And in this video I want to find out if we can dry the filament in the microwave or not. As you can see, the sticker is already removed. I'm recording this after the first testing is finished, and there will be several more. Sticker is removed because it will go into water several days. This was quite a big torture for this filament, but let's see the first experiment. I'm starting with checking of the scale, though I need to calibrate it, but it is still accurate. And I'm measuring this PETG, the start weight.
1077.75.
Placing it into water, and density of the PETG is heavier than the water, so it will sink. And after 3 days I'm taking it out, and one day it will be outside, and now currently it is almost 90% relative humidity outside, you can see on these drops. So I will start the experiment, and I will first measure this pool. 1102.75 grams. This is 1000 watts microwave, and I will do 30 seconds drying, and I will measure the filament, and in the meantime I will try to keep the break of half minutes, and I will continue until I can see some change in the weight. I can see some moisture on it. These breaks are good for this moisture to evaporate from the surface too, quite a lot at the beginning. Probably my method is not the best, because usually you will not start drying PETG after placing it in water a few days. After 6 measuring I will place the spool in opposite position now. There are drops on the surface, and on a touch I can feel that it is approximately 50 or even 60 degrees Celsius, because it starts to hurt, and I can compare, for example, with the bed temperature. This is the last tent measuring before this bigger break, and I explain you why. Maybe you can see this moisture inside the spool, and I can see it constantly changes. If I wait a little bit, you will see that the weight reduces slowly, because this evaporates from the surface. I decided to place it a half hour into a conventional filament dryer, because I can see even moisture inside the spool, and hopefully this will reduce it a little bit. And I really like this property of this filament dryer, that it rotates the spool during the drying. Even after 1.5 hours of drying, I can see that moisture stuck inside, so I think this is a bad idea, but I think I will stop this experiment here. I can see quite a lot of moisture which stuck inside. And I think I can get rid of it only if I print it and with unrolling of the spool. I can see it lost quite a lot of moisture, but it still has at least 10 grams more than before placing into water. This is the result of the first part. So this is the weight before the water, and after placing the water it got 25 grams of the water. And this is the drying in the microwave. This is the break of 30 seconds. And this is completely deformed, because quite a lot of water drops I had inside the spool. And after this I placed it in 1.5 hours in the filament dryer, and this was the final weight, which is only 7.9 grams compared to the start weight, which is not bad considering that it had the visible drops inside. And after this I printed the benchy. I wasn't too happy with this test, because this is not a real life situation. I mean, nobody will place its filament into water, so I needed some other testings too. Even after 6 hours I can see that water which was pushed out by the microwave, so it can really dry the filament, only this was too big amount of the moisture. So the first conclusion, don't store your filaments in the water. And now I can understand how useful are these holes on the side of the spool. Just to check my theory that the outer loops are dried, I'm printing this benchy, and I hope it's visible on camera too that there is no stringing, so this means this part of the filament is completely dry. And now 1 month later, this filament was stored on the open air. And the filament can get that stable state from both directions, actually, by absorbing moisture. But in this case, this filament have a lot of water in it, so properly it reduced the weight. And I cannot see those water spots drops inside anymore. Maybe 1 month is not really enough to get that completely stable state, but we will see soon. At least I also have this jump PETG filament, which was stored on the open air 1 year, but I have only 40 grams on it. I'm not sure if I can measure something, and probably the carbon spool have some moisture in it, but let's do the testing and see if I can measure something. Only now it starts to be hot, approximately 55-60 degrees Celsius. And this result looks more like a real drying curve, where we have the heat up stage, and this is the drying part, and maybe I could continue a little bit more to see how it became near horizontal value, but I can see this graph only now, not during the drying. But don't forget, this was quite a small amount of the filament. More filament needs more time and energy for the drying. Here I reached those 55, maybe even 60 degrees Celsius after 3 or 4 drying on these 30 seconds. Creality CR PETG. After 1 month on open air, it should be drier than in the first test, but let's try to dry it even more. Again, it is hard to see change in the weight because the water is pushed out from the filament, but it is stuck inside the spool. Yes, the water is inside, and a bigger spool needs more time to heat up. I can see approximately it is 50 or 55 degrees Celsius, but I measure it and this will be the last heating actually. And now it goes to the filament dryer 1 hour. 65 degrees Celsius. And I can see those water drops almost completely disappeared. I can see on this side view. On the other side there are no water drops. Only inside I can see some. So not bad drying method. Combination of two. Now this graph is probably still deformed because of those water drops which were pushed out from the filament to the surface, but they stuck inside the spool. Now interesting to notice that here, because of this bigger mass, only after approximately 6 drying on these 30 seconds, it reached those 55-60 degrees Celsius where I recommend stop drying this PETG filament. In microwave, of course. But interesting additional weight loss was when I placed in the filament dryer, so this combination of two dryings is quite good. It's time to move to more serious materials. This is PPA-CF, and I even wrote down the date and when I place it in this vacuum storage. And usually I notice that even here it absorbs approximately 1 gram per week, at least at the beginning. So this was the weight approximately 1 month ago. Actually not bad, only 1 gram it absorbed during this almost 1 month. Okay, good to know. Looks like some metallic sticker, wow. So what is the first thing YouTuber will grab when he sees fire? Yes, the camera. Interesting, I didn't know that this stick tape have some metal parts in it, so be careful if you will not use this hose, but you want to glue the end of the filament. The damage is not big, only the carbon spool is damaged a little bit and the end of the filament, but I will just cut off. Only now I ruined my measuring because it don't have that start weight anymore. Okay, I measured it again, so second attempt. It wasn't the stick tape. And now I'm definitely confused. Is it because of the carbon fiber or the PPA filament? It started here and this part of the filament catched fire, which is separated from the bulk mass. This needs more testing. This is ASA-CF to see if the carbon fiber is causing this problem. I unrolled here approximately 10 meters and I'm doing this experiment so you don't have to do it at home. And don't forget, some bamboo spools have that chip or tag inside and they cannot go into the microwave. So far it looks like it's obvious, so carbon fiber cannot go inside the microwave. Probably why we get comments, it's so obvious, but it wasn't to me so far. What about the glass fibers? I want to play more with the fire. This is PPA-CF. And for the end, the glass fiber nylon PPA-CF. Okay, glass fiber is fine. Well, it looks like the glass fiber is fine, but carbon fiber no. And I know that we get some comments that it was so obvious, but it wasn't so obvious to me, at least. I didn't know about this so far. I mean, I know that the metal cannot go into microwave, but carbon fiber, okay. And don't worry about my microwave, if it breaks or something like that. I hope that Patreon supporters will don't mind if I buy a new one, but I needed this experiment, so you don't have to do it yourself. Well, now I have to clean this mess. Actually, my biggest problem currently is to clean this mess before my wife arrives. I have only 1 hour before she arrives home. And I'm lucky that she stopped watching my videos, otherwise I would have a very big problem. This sofa only looks nice, but it is very uncomfortable for sleeping. Just to see how obvious was the answer, I asked ChatGPT what he thinks which of these three filaments will catch fire in the microwave. And he gave me the wrong answer. And I asked, are you sure? I had fire with the CF filament in the microwave. And of course this became obvious that it was the carbon fiber. So actually he could become one of those commenters on my channel. First conclusion. But it looks like these carbon fibers act like some conductive materials and they cannot go into microwave. I wasn't sure about this, but don't even try these kind of silly things at home. I'm brave because even if I earn only $10 per video from YouTube ads, I have my Patreon donations and I can use them to cover these kind of things if necessary. But microwave survives, so everything is okay here. The second thing, drying regular materials like PETG, it is possible, but maybe in two steps. First, dry it in microwave, but maybe you should dry it in 30 second sequences and then touch it. If it is too hot, then you can stop drying within in a microwave and place it in a conventional filament dryer. Any cheap filament dryer which moves the air will be fine, because the microwave is good to force that moisture to the surface of the filament, but after this it is good if we place it in a conventional dryer, and in that case that hot air will evaporate that water from that surface. This is my experience with the drying in the microwave. If you have some additional experience or you know exactly what's happening with these carbon fibers in the microwave, then write me your lies down in the comment section. Thank you for watching and happy printing!